This is a vehicle with a two-man crew. This is a driver and the commander. And for a tactical purpose, this is a sliding bridge. The boxer goes into the position to the rear, and the bridge then is laid down by the commander to the rear. The reason for this, why do we put the bridge to the rear, is that the power pack is in the front, and this is the counterweight for the vehicle pushing to the rear.
So the vehicle's here, it deploys everything off the back. Exactly. Let's walk around it and talk about the bridge itself.
What you see here is a 22-meter bridge for medium forces, like the 8x8 Boxer, which up to a weight of a military load class 50 ton, which is more or less this type of vehicle.
A tank is a little bit too heavy for it. It's APCs, it's medium-sized military vehicles can go across that.
It's exactly what we see here, but we can apply to this vehicle also a 14-meter bridge up to MLC 80, and this would then also be capable for crossing of a Challenger, of a Leopard 2 main battle tank, vehicles like this class.
How quickly can it deploy the bridge?
Which has a deployment is within minutes, but the issue is you go under protection to the position where you lay down the bridge, and you lay the complete bridge, the complete performance is under protection for the crew. Nobody has to leave the vehicle. Then the vehicle is able to drive over its own bridge to the other side, take it again up, and drive on. This is possible. Yeah.
So give me a scenario where this might be used in a military context in the field.
Yeah. One typical cross capability you need if you have an attack and you try to advance, and then you have a brigade, and here typically a brigade of wheeled vehicles. Then you need at a certain distance or size of rivers, you need such a vehicle, such a bridge for crossing, and then you have everything available. You do not need to wait, because the boxer will drive together in the brigade with the other boxers.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.